Remember this portion of the story of God as it is written in the book that we love. We will be reading from the book of Chronicles. Therefore, David blessed the Lord before all the assembly, and David said, "Blessed are you, Lord God of Israel, our Father, forever and ever. Yours, O Lord, is the greatness, the power and the glory, the victory and the majesty. For all that is in heaven and in earth is yours. Yours is the kingdom, O Lord, and you are exalted as head over all. Both riches and honor come from you, and you reign over all. In your hand is power and might. In your hand it is to make great and to give strength to all. Now, therefore, our God, we thank you and praise your glorious name. But who am I and who are my people that we shall be able to offer so willingly as this? For all things come from you, and of your own we have given you. For we are the aliens and pilgrims before you, and were all our fathers. Our days on earth are as a shadow and without hope. O Lord, our God, all this abundance that we have prepared to build you a house for your holy name is from your hand and is all your own. I know also, my God, that you test the heart and have pleasure in uprightness. As for me, in the uprightness of my heart, I have willingly offered all these things, and now with joy I have seen your people who are present here to offer willingly to you. O Lord God of Abraham, Isaac, and Israel, our fathers, keep this forever in the intent of the thoughts of the heart of your people, and fix their heart towards you." This is a word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Indeed, welcome to this Sunday as we continue to learn from the month of the Open Door Generosity Uplifted Kingdom Supply. I see you all have neighbors. Turn to them and tell them, "Karibuni sana." Turn to your other neighbor and tell them, "Welcome to the month of Uplifted Kingdom Supply." I hope you're giving them a smile. Even though it's chilly this morning, we give God the glory. I'm sure even in our hearts, we give God all the praise and all the glory, even as we step into this service. If you're watching us for the very first time on a social media platform, that is YouTube and Facebook at Parklands Baptist Church, it is an honor to usher you into this service. Please make sure, if you're joining us for the very first time, mention it on the comment section. Our social media team will show you how you can plug into the Parky family. If you're here for the first time for the in-service experience, you are here for the first time, Parky family. We have our Karibu Center as you're exiting through the main entrance to your right. We have a blue tent with our leaders and our deacons just to show you how you can plug into Parky family. Indeed, we give God the glory and the praise. This is the Holy Communion Sunday. We just want to welcome everybody to this service. Continue to share where you're watching us from, even as you share with your neighbor what has stood out for you this month, being that we are tapping into God's generosity. How are you blessing the people around you with what you have? Are you a blessing to your family in the marketplace where we spend most of our time, here in the church? Are you having an uplifted kingdom supply? For scripture says that God is a giver of all things, and that he's the owner of cattle of 1,000 hills. So what are you asking God for this Sunday, even as you look up unto him for your presence and for your blessing? We also see a few comments online. I see Catherine, who was joining from 8:06, saying, "Waiting. I hope you have seen the service has started." I see Rachel Wangoi saying, "Watching and joining from Gikambura." Karibu Rachel. I see Diana Chepkemoi saying she's watching from Gathiga. She will be coming for the second service. We hope to see you here. I see Reverend Ken Odor saying, good morning, Paki family. I am watching from Kampala, Uganda, and I'm ready to learn and be blessed. Thank you so much, Reverend Ken Odor. Lastly, I see Ben O saying, morning, Paki family, cold weather, but in Christ we are warm. Be blessed, watching all the way from Kiru. Lastly, Joyce Muthoni saying, happy to be in the house of the Lord. Receive greetings from Dar es Salaam. I love Paki. We love you too, Joyce Muthoni. Continue to share where you're watching us from. And I see someone saying they're watching from Uganda. Indeed, we are spreading the gospel to the ends of the world. Now, just to bring you up to speed with what is happening, we have our candidates prayer session on the 28th of April. We hope to see you there, even as we pray for our candidates from 2 p.m. to 4 p.m. at the pavilion. We are standing with you, candidates, and we know that you will thrive and supply all that God needs for you to be who He has called you to be. And I also see we have a family discipleship conference on the 4th of May. This will be held at Nairobi Baptist Church at along Gong Road. We hope to see all our families represented there. This is partnership of Parklands Baptist Church and the Nairobi Baptist family. We hope to see all of you there, even as we congregate and give God the glory. Now, this is a time for us just to say a short word of prayer, even as we invite God's presence. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day. We thank you because you have given us to rejoice and be glad in it. Thank you for everybody who has joined us for the in-person and everybody who's joining us on the virtual platform. We thank you because this is a month of open-door generosity, and indeed we are tapping into your abundance even as you use us as vessels for uplifted kingdom supply. We give you glory, we give you thanks, even as we stand in your presence. May you move and have your will on our lives, Jehovah. May we release a sound of praise and a shout of victory for the tent of the righteous. We thank you. We give you glory for the families represented here, even for the praise and worship we're about to offer to you. May you receive it as a pleasant offering. We give you praise. We give you glory, for you alone deserve it. For this we have prayed, believing and trusting in the name above every other name, the name of Jesus. And the people of God say, amen. Now, congregation, this is the moment where we join our vocalist and band to worship our Lord in truth and in spirit.
morning, because only you can satisfy everything and anything we need. In Jesus' name, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen, amen. Good morning, church. Good morning, church. I know it's a cold morning, but are you glad to be in the house of the Lord? Come on, let me hear you give a shout. Please be on your feet. Get some space, at least since it's cold, you can get some warmth. Eh? Amen. Amen.
Hi. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
just look at how your life has been. Look at all the things that God has brought you through. Amen. And just take some time and thank Him. Because He's a mighty God, a God of wonders, a God of provision, a healer. So take this time, thank Him, just adore Him.
Hosanna, Hosanna. Save me. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Heavenly Father, you are worthy. You are worthy, you are worthy, you are worthy to be praised and to be honored this morning. Church, we can give thanks to the Lord by clapping our hands, because indeed he is worthy of all our praise. Let us go to the Lord in prayer. Our Heavenly Father, we are so grateful this morning because of your goodness and your kindness to us. The Lord, you've kept every one of us safe and brought us to worship you again. Father, we bring our thanksgiving to you, even as we bring our testimonies to your sanctuary this morning, because indeed you've been good to us the whole week. Praise and honor and glory to your holy and mighty name. Father, we want to thank you because of the favor that you've continued to give to every one of us. The gift of good health, the gift of life, oh Lord, we don't take anything for granted. We are here this morning to say thank you to you. We thank you, Lord, even for the rains that are going on in this country. We pray that Heavenly Father, this will be a source of bumper harvest for this nation so that we can be food secure, because you are the one who provides for us. You are Jehovah Jireh. And Heavenly Father, therefore, we are grateful and we pray. The Lord, you are going to enable the farmers to plant, and that, Lord, you are going to take care of our farms so that we can have sufficiency in our land in the name of Jesus. We are praying the Lord even come through and even sort out the confusion in that sector about the fertilizers, about the seeds. We are praying that, Lord, bring order in that sector in the name of Jesus. Heavenly Father, we want to thank you that over the week so many people have traveled, and especially over the weekend, and that, Lord, you have watched over them, oh God. We give you thanks for those who are able to accomplish their assignments and they are back to their stations, and even those who are traveling today, we commit them to you and pray that, Lord, may you watch over them and protect them in Jesus' name. We are especially grateful this morning for our families. Thank you that, Lord, you have watched over us, oh God. You have watched over our children when they are on holiday at home. And even, Lord, you have kept our families supplied and cared for. We give you thanks and we give you praise, Jehovah God. Thank you, Lord, for your favor upon every family this morning. We give you thanks and give you praise. And Lord, we humble ourselves because we count on your goodness. Some of the things that we have, we don't deserve. It is your goodness and mercies. And therefore, Father, again, receive our thanksgiving this morning in the name of Jesus. Even as a church, you have continued to sustain us, O Lord, and we are grateful. We thank you for even successful Bible club that ended last Friday. We give you thanks even for your word that was planted in your children. We are praying that, Lord, it shall bear more fruit in the name of Jesus. Therefore, Heavenly Father, receive our thanksgiving, receive our praises, and receive our adoration. Church, we can join together to thank the Lord for his goodness. In your own way, you know what the Lord has done. Give him thanks and give him praise because he is good. Our Heavenly Father, this morning, we bring our petitions and prayers to you, O God, because you are good. And Heavenly Father, as a nation, we are mourning because of what happened to our KDF people. We want to pray, O God, this morning, that you may remember the affected families this morning, O God. We remember the family of the Chief of Defense Forces this morning. Even as they lay him to rest, O God, we are praying. May your peace that surpasses all understanding cover them and comfort them in the name of the Lord. And even stand with all the other affected families, Jehovah, King of Heaven. Even we remember that one of them belongs to this church. We are praying that, God of Heaven, remember those families, Jehovah, King of Glory. We are praying that, Lord, may you cover them. And because the Bible says that you are close to the brokenhearted, Father, we pray that you visit all those families in the name of the Lord. And Heavenly Father, in that breath we are praying, may you grant us safety on our roads. Grant us safety in the airs of this country, O God. Grant us safety on the waters of this land in the name of Jesus. We want to rise against the spirit of accidents in Jesus' name. We bind the demons and the spirits that cause this chaos, O God. And we are praying that, Lord, keep us safe. Keep us safe, O God, even as we leave and return in the name of Jesus. We are remembering the many people who've been affected by accidents of late, and we are praying that, Lord, you bring this one to an end in the name of Jesus. Father, we remember the many other families that are bereaved this morning, and especially Pastor Washira, who's lost his wife. We are praying that Jehovah, King of Heaven, you may comfort him in the name of Jesus. Even Pastor Victor, who laid his sister-in-law to rest last Tuesday, we are praying that, Lord, you may comfort him. And many other families in this church, we are praying that Jehovah God, bring your peace upon such families in the name of the Lord. We also praying for those who are affected by the current floods in various parts of this country. We are praying that, Lord, you also bring a solution to this because you are able. We are praying that, Lord, may you surround them with your peace and with your care, even at this time in the name of the Lord. Protect them from disease in the name of Jesus. We uplift our country, Kenya, before you this morning. We are praying for your peace. We are praying for your stability in the name of Jesus. We are praying that, Lord, you revive our economy. We pray that, Lord, our industries will recover in the name of Jesus. We are praying that our businesses will flourish in the name of the Lord. We are praying that, Lord, you may bless our careers this morning, O God, so that, Father, your people be promoted, their jobs will be doing well, so that they can be supplied in the name of Jesus. We want to remember in a special way the youth in this country. We are praying that they may all come to the knowledge of Jesus Christ and your saving grace, so that they can walk in your ways, they can be protected and cared for, and their lives hidden under your care in the name of the Lord. We pray that, Lord of Heaven, you remember the families that are battling various things, O God, relationships, challenges, O God. Those who are battling with sicknesses this morning, those who are battling economic challenges, O God. We are praying that you may come for every one of them. Those who are working on programs and projects, that, Lord, you see them through in the name of Jesus. Father, we continue to pray that even in this month of April, as we focus on the kingdom, open door generosity, we are praying that, Lord, you be generous to every one of us in this church in the name of Jesus. We pray that you extend your generosity to every family this morning in the name of the Lord. And may we all experience your goodness. We love you and we worship you this morning for hearing our prayer. And we pray that, Lord, even as we progress in this service, may your presence cover us, O God. May your goodness be upon us, O Lord. May your word be upon our Pastor Simon as he comes to bring your word this morning. We pray that, Lord, may you bless us as we begin, even when we end, and all glory and honor shall be to you. We prayed all these things with thanksgiving in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Spirit. And the whole church said, amen. The church said, amen. Amen. We can give a clap to the Lord, and you may have your seats in the presence of the Lord. And you are very welcome. It's very nice to see all of you this morning. And from where I am standing, you are all looking very good. Even though it is cold and drizzling, but you have made it to church. You are very, very, very welcome. So I want to take this opportunity, as even those who are coming in are settling down, to welcome those who are coming to this church for the very first time. So if it's your very first time to come to Parky, you've not been here before, this is your very first time, please, by a show of hand, let's see where you are so that we can appreciate you. Who has seen a hand? I can see that hand. Welcome, welcome, welcome. It's very nice to have you. Another hand somewhere? Yes, very welcome. It's nice to have you. Very welcome. When I hear hands, I know near where those hands are, there is a hand somewhere. Anyone this way? This way? Good. This way, I think I saw, yeah. You're very welcome. Nice to see you. This one we saw, and then this side, here. These are the corners of Wenyeji. This side, you're welcome, sir. Nice to see you. Welcome. We can appreciate them better. This side, oh yes. Thank you very much. Welcome. It's nice to have you. Then here. Yes, we have two hands. Very good. And then here. Very good. Now, after this service, through this door, to my right, there is a blue tent. It is rather cold this morning, and we are waiting for you with a cup of tea and coffee to welcome you to this church. So please, after the service, ensure that you get into that tent. We are waiting for you to get to know you better. And because you have come, and you are quite a number of you, worship team, there is a welcome here. Yes, we can do that. Please go ahead. There's a welcome here. There's a Christian welcome. There's a welcome here. There's a welcome here. There's a Christian welcome here. God loves you and I love you, and that's the way it should be. Hallelujah. God loves you and I love you, and that's the way it should be. Thank you very much. We appreciate all of you. I want to acknowledge the presence also in our midst among guests, Deacon Malcolm and his son Matthew. They are from First Baptist Houston, and they have come to be with us. They are seated right here. We want to say thank you. They've come before. They are our great partners. They've given us support in Northgate through their church, and we want to say thank you very much, and you're very welcome. Also wanting to welcome those who've been traveling to Kankaupa, and your family just traveled to South Africa, and they're back. The family is here also, and they're also visiting. Yeah. Dr. Kaupa's family, if you don't mind, you can stand. We see all of you. It's been a while. Yes, they are all here. Thank you very much. It's nice to see you. And we can see the granddaughter has grown. Very good. We thank you. Please have your seats, and God bless you. Very well. That done, I would like us now to go to the Lord's table. And therefore, I'm changing positions and changing mics. Because we'd like to do this when our children are still in the house, so that also those who are going to the Sunday school, they have an opportunity to do this. And my task is easier today because I don't have the big bread, so I'll be breaking the small one, and therefore the task is easier. And so things are good for me. But I want to say that we do this, and those who are at home, those who are following us online, please welcome very much. And church, we can actually appreciate those who are following this service online this morning, and to remind them that we have the Lord's table now, and as we do what we are doing, please go for your bread, go for your drink, and at home you are even free to have tea in this cold morning where we are having what we are having here. So what we do is go to the Lord. And therefore, this morning I want to remind us that we are invited to the Lord's table. And today we are calling it the table of open door generosity. This is what the Lord is inviting us to this morning. That because of his generosity, he gave the best. And that's what the Bible says in John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish but have eternal life. God gave and gave the best. His only one begotten Son. And therefore, there can be no other generosity like this, that one would give the best. And when he was giving Jesus Christ, actually he gave himself. Because we say God is a Trinity. Not that he gave and he remained. It is him who came and gave himself. And there is no higher gift than somebody giving themselves to you. We buy each other gifts. We do things for one another. But rarely do we give ourselves. And that is why we are told marriage is like the example of God and his bride. Because it is in marriages that people give one another as gifts. You give yourself away. You know, that is the only example of how great. Because other things, we give you a gift, but we go, the whole of us go away. But in marriage, you give yourself. Have you seen this picture? That actually you surrender your life. God generously gave himself to us. And therefore, when we are talking about the bread, the body of Jesus Christ, it is God himself. That's how generous God is. He has given himself to us. And therefore, we are members of his kingdom. And number two, is the Bible says in Romans 5:8, that God demonstrates his love towards us, that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. Meaning, the generosity is not because we deserve it. It is because he loves us. It is not because we have worked for it. It is because he has worked for it. And that's why in the book of Isaiah, chapter 55 and verse 1, the Bible says, "Come, all of you who are thirsty, come to the waters, and you who have no money, come and buy and eat. Come buy wine and milk without money, without cost." Meaning every cost has been paid for us. And therefore this morning, I invite you to this table of generosity without money. You just need to believe and accept, and you are invited. The garment that is needed for this is righteousness. And Christ is our righteousness. Amen. And therefore, I'd like you now to open your elements. Open your elements. We open the first seal. And you will get bread. And therefore, we can give thanks when you have it. Because the Bible says, in the same way, after supper, he took the cup, saying, "This cup is now the new covenant in my blood. Do this whenever you drink of it in remembrance of me. For whenever you eat this bread and drink the cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. So then, whosoever eats the bread and drinks the cup of the Lord in an unworthy manner will be guilty of sinning against the body and the blood of the Lord." And therefore, church, take time and just cleanse yourself. Prepare your heart to be ready to receive the generous gift of God. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you for your body that was broken, so that today we can have it together and demonstrate your kindness and generosity to us. And in this, we do in remembrance of you, who paid the price of our sin, and even paid the price for us to be reconciled back to you. And we pray that even as we do this morning, may the fullness of your goodness be found in our lives. May our bodies be restored. May our situations be corrected, even to your blueprint this morning. Father, we take this bread with thanksgiving. In Jesus' name, let's take together. The Bible says that in the same way he took the cup, and after giving thanks, he told them to take, and therefore you can open the second seal, and you can be able to access the drink. And when you have opened, we can give thanks and be able to take together. Our Heavenly Father, we are grateful to you. Because of the blood that Jesus Christ shed on the cross, our sins have been washed away. And because of that blood, we have victory over sin, we have victory over every situation that we face. And therefore, our Heavenly Father, we take this cup with thanksgiving in unity, and we bless it before you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Church, we can take together. Let us pray, even as you meditate on the goodness of the Lord. Our loving Heavenly Father, we bow before your presence, appreciating the table of open door generosity to us this morning. And Heavenly Father, we are praying that whoever is seeking anything this morning, out of your generosity, Lord, open the door for them. Those who are seeking healing, we declare their healing in Jesus' name. Those who are seeking victory in various ways, we declare that victory in Jesus' name. Those who are seeking for favor, we ask that they receive their favor this morning in Jesus' name. And therefore, Father, we are grateful and we honor your name. We pray this with thanksgiving in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And we all say it, amen. God bless you. Now I go to announcements. And before I go to the announcements, I would like to release our children to go to their Sunday school. So if all the children can stand wherever they are, we wanted them to be part of the Lord's table. We thank God for all the children, and we love them. And therefore, extend your hands towards the children, even as we bless them this morning. Pastor Simon says when he sees them, he feels goosebumps. Yes, children are great. Let's bless them. Our Heavenly Father, we want to thank you for the gift of children. We see them, we see our future. We see your favor towards us, O God, and we see your goodness in them. And therefore, Father, we release them this morning to go to their Sunday school with your blessing. And we pray that, Lord, may they learn and may they be shaped by your word, even to be the people that you want them to be. We bless their teachers this morning and pray that may your hand be upon them as well. We bless them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And the church said, amen. And we can release them with a song, Jesus Loves Me. This I know.
Jesus loves me, this I know. For the Bible tells me so. Little ones to him belong. They are weak, but he is strong. Yes, yes. Loves me, the Bible tells me so.
Very well, preserve the seats for the parents who have gone out so that when they come back, they can find their seats. I'd like to bring us announcements this morning, and I want to start with the wedding bands. I'd like to announce the wedding between Joseph Situma Haemba and Patricia Chebet Tung, that is scheduled for 4th of May 2024 at Karen Country Club. And this is the second announcement. Is Joseph Stuma and Patricia in the house? Ah, they are there. Good, you may stand. Even as we appreciate them. And are your parents around or anybody who has accompanied you? Who are supporting these guys to get married? Please, wow. Yeah, even brothers and sisters. Wow, this is serious support. We can appreciate this family. And we see parents from both sides. Thank you for coming. We wish you all the best. May the Lord go ahead of you and may your wedding be glorious. But when they are still on their feet, because we must say this, if anybody thinks they should not get married, let the pastors know in good time. But in the meantime, let's pray for them and wish them all the best. And families, you are blessed, and thank you for coming. You may have your seats. I also want to announce the wedding between John Brainhand Waweru Mugo and Doris Wanjiru Munyingi on 10th May 2024 at Lake House Tigoni, and this is the first announcement. Is John and Doris here in the house? Are they? Maybe they will come for the second announcement, but here we are. But in the same tone, if you have any reason why John and Doris should not get married, let us know in good time. But in the meantime, we pray for them. Amen. Thank you so much. Now, I'd like to bring another announcement, and this one is a sad one. You all know when we announced last Sunday that the wife to our pastor, Washira Murethi, Joy Rugano Washira, has rested in the Lord. And you can see her picture on the screen. That happened on 6th of April in the UK, and the body has already arrived in Kenya. The burial is scheduled for Friday the 26th in Karatina in Nyeri County. There will be a funeral service here on Thursday this week, starting at 10 a.m. Please plan and come. And also plan to be able to attend Karatina, those who are able to do so. Support and prayer meetings will be happening tomorrow, Monday, and Tuesday, at the pavilion from 5:30 p.m. And you are welcome. Let's continue to pray for this family and believe God for his support and standing with them. And even especially praying for our pastor, Washira, in Jesus' name. I bring now another announcement, but this is a good one. And let's say Paki Fariji, registration is on. And you know, Fariji is a program that helps those who are bereaved when the unfortunate happens, so that we have a cover that can be able to support families. Registration is going on after this service in this tent, outside this door, the former overflow tent, please. Please go there and register. There will be a candidate's prayer day this coming Sunday at 2 p.m. to 4 p.m. at the pavilion. Therefore, all the candidates for 2024, let's gather at the pavilion next Sunday. You are welcome with your parents. We also have Family Discipleship Conference 2024, and we have a clip for this. So if the clip can play, but the poster is there.
Greetings, Nairobi Baptist Church family.
Greetings, Parklands Baptist Church family.
We are here to welcome our church families to this year's Family Discipleship Conference, which will be taking place at...
It will be taking place in Nairobi Baptist Church on the 4th of May, starting from 8 a.m. to 2 p.m.
We have a great theme this year, which is drawn from the book of Judges, chapter 2, verse 10. And the theme is...
Our theme this year is amazing. It is one generation away, hashtag... Tell the generations.
Our keynote speaker will be Dr. George Ogalo, picking up from last year's conference. You do not want to miss this year's session. And our hosts will be our senior pastors, Reverend Ambrose Nyangao
and Reverend Munengi Mulandi.
Kindly register in advance through our discipleship ministries and mobilize your family, friends, and invite them to this year's Family Discipleship Conference. God bless you.
Thank you very much. You are invited. So please diarise and plan to attend. Now it's time for giving, and we can rejoice because God has given us. It is time for us to be able to give back to him. And we bless the Lord for his generosity to us. And we have various ways of giving, and details are available on the screen. For those who are going to be giving through M-Pesa, we have our PayBill number, which is on the screen, 890900. Again, I repeat, PayBill number 890900. You can also give through the church account, which is the Parklands Baptist Church, Stanbic Bank, branches of Yakiwe, and you can see the details of the accounts there. Those who would like to swipe your cards through the exit door, we have a reception desk. You can be able to swipe your cards there. Then those who have carried cash this morning, I invite our ushers to be here with their baskets so that we can be able to give there. And those who require envelopes, you can be able to collect them and be able to put your offerings even as we do that. So therefore, ushers, take your positions. They're available for you at various corners, and we'll be able to do that. So let's give thanks for the offerings because you have them ready, and then we shall be giving when the worship team will be giving us the hymn. And in the meantime, let's appreciate the worship team for the good job. You can clap for them. African theme, looking very nice. And thank you so much, and God bless you. Let's pray. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you for your goodness to us. Thank you for your generosity to us. As we give our offerings and our tithes this morning, it's a sign of our gratitude to you. It's also our worship to you. We pray that, Lord, you may bless what we give to you this morning. And Lord, we pray that you also bless our going out and our coming in, and extend our horizons in the name of Jesus, and fill our stores afresh in Jesus' name. We pray that, Lord, whatever we do with what you give to us as a church, may it be for your glory and honor. Bless us now and forevermore. In Jesus' name we prayed. Amen and amen. God bless you, and enjoy the rest of the service. Worship team, you are welcome.
Asante. Let's appreciate Deacon Wairagu. And as we do that, I'd request us to be up on our feet. Amen. We just want to continue celebrating Jesus for the powerful gift, the generous gift of his son. Amen. We want to continue celebrating our God for the generous gift of his son. Amen. Jesus. And we want to sing of the power of the cross. Hallelujah. So sing with us this morning. Amen. Amen. We know this song, amen. Let's sing it.